إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، أوصي نفسي وإياكم بتقوى الله، فقد فاز المتقون. قال تعالى: إن للمتقين مفازة. أحبابي، أمامنا سنة ربانية، وفي قلوب أمامنا سنة ربانية وفي قلوب الراسخين عبرة وعظة، أن البلاء الذي نصاب به والنقم التي تحل إنما هي بسبب الذنوب والمعاصي. فقد قال تعالى: وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم. ويقول تعالى: وهو الذي ينزل الغيث من بعد ما قنطوا وينشر رحمته وهو الولي الحميد. Brothers in Iman, my topic for today is about calamities, causes and cures. Why are we facing calamities as Ummah now? In Turkey and in Syria, they experienced earthquakes. In Kenya, and more precisely in the northern region, they have been challenged, where we all know majority of the population in northern Kenya are Muslims, and yet Allah Azza wa Jalla has given them a challenge, a calamity, drought, which is making people to have sleepless night. Children are not having food to eat. Parents are suffering. People don't have water to drink. Animals are dying. And yet, me and you are here in Nairobi, walillahi alhamd, doing our normal business. After every 20 minutes, you open your fridge, you either remove a cold water or a cold juice or a cold drink, and you quench your thirst. And yet our brothers are suffering. But nobody is even trying to sit down, analyze the problem, try to come up with a solution, try to see, is there any solution to this drought? Normally, the nature of human beings, it's either we feel it, we see it, we touch it. But because most of us are here, yes, the sun is very hot, but when you go inside your car, there's AC. So you'll forget after some few minutes that it was hot outside. But your brother in Marsabit, your brother in Moyale, your brother in Mandera, your brother in Wajir, your brother in Garissa, your brother in Tana River is suffering. He cannot sleep well at night because of the heat. Some of the children are not going to school because they are helping their parents to go and look for water. What are the causes of this drought? Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا قَنَتُ وَيَنْشُرُ رَحْمَتَهُ وَهُوَ الْوَلِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. And it is Allah Azza wa Jalla who brings down the rain. After what? After people have reached the end. Qanatu. They have no other hope. Then Allah said, وَيَنْشُرُ رَحْمَةً, and He spreads His mercy. You'll find that Allah Azza wa Jalla has defined in the Quran two types of rains. There's the one that is halak and azab. وَأَمْتَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مَطَرًا فَسَاءَ مَطَرُ الْمُنْذَرِينَ. And there's another one that is rahmah, that me and you and each and every Muslim should be asking Allah to give us. One of them is this ayah, وَهُوَ الَّذِي يُنَزِّلُ الْغَيْثَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا قَنَتُ. Al-ghayth, the terminology that Allah Azza wa Jalla have used here is ghayth. The reason that Allah Azza wa Jalla used this term here is because this does not only make the earth to come back to life, it also brings tranquility to your heart as a believer. It brings tranquility to human, to mankind. Once they see the rain falls, they're like, now, oh, alhamdulillah, now we are going to do plantation, our animals are going to have water, alhamdulillah, now we are going to get out of this problem that we are facing. That is why Allah Azza wa Jalla used the ghayth, because it has two benefits. First one is in your heart as a believer. Number two, for the earth. غير أن المطر قد يتأخر نزولهم لأسباب يجنيها الناس بأيديهم. But the problem is sometimes rain takes time to come. In Kenya now, they are saying it's the longest drought, I don't know in how many years. Muslims have gone out to do istisqa, but still we are still having droughts. What is the problem? Where have we gone wrong? What are we doing that is causing all these problems?
ويقارفها بفعالهم فيكون ذلك جزاء لهم على ضعف إيمانهم وتنبيها لهم على بعدهم عن ربهم.
So sometimes these droughts takes time so that me and you, we need to sit down and reflect and ask ourselves, are we the reason that Allah is not bringing the rains? Is it me? Is it you? Who is causing this problem? Where is the problem coming from?
والأسباب كثيرة نقتصر منها أربعة.
The reasons are many, but inshallah today I will try and talk about four. Four major reasons that are bringing us this problem, that are causing this calamity to prolong.
Number one, كثرة المعاصي وهي من الأسباب الموجبة لحبس المطر عن الناس وانتشار القحط والجفاف لأن المعاصي سبيل لإغضاب الرب سبحانه وتعالى وقد لا يقتصر أثرها على أصحابها بل يتعداها إلى غيرها قال تعالى ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما الفساد القحط وقلة النبات وذهاب البركة.
The first reason is that we have concentrated, focused in doing the wrong deeds. Day in, day out, we are doing ma'asi, wal'iyadu billah. Because the only reason that Allah Azza wa Jalla can stop rains to come down is when He's angry. And one of the major things that is going to make Allah Azza wa Jalla become angry is if he see a believer doing ma'asiyah. In the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna Allah yaghar." Allah Azza wa Jalla becomes jealous Why is Allah Azza wa Jalla becoming jealous? Why? Because you prayed Isha? No. Because you give sadaqah? No. Because you did good deeds? No. It's because you are doing ma'asi. If a believer does any mistakes, Allah Azza wa Jalla becomes angry. I will explain to you why. It's because Allah Azza wa Jalla loves his creatures. And once you love something, then if you love someone and you see him doing something wrong, you feel bad. If you, as a person, if your brother does you wrong, you become angry. If your sister does you wrong, you become angry. How about Allah Azza wa Jalla? He has given everything. He has provided for you everything that you want. And yet, instead of having at least haya, you don't even have that haya, you go on and continue doing ma'asi. Wal'iyadu billah. Ibn Abbas, when he was doing tafsir of this ayah, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر, he said الفساد, القحط. Fasad is what? Is drought. وعدم البركة. Each and every businessman knows this. There is no barakah in our wealth now. We are complaining about inflation. Yes, there is inflation. We are complaining about the economy. Yes, there is problem with the economy. But is there another root cause for us having these problems? It is ma'asi. وقال أبو عالية من عصى الله في الأرض فقد أفسد فيها. Anyone who does anything wrong on this earth, فقد فسد فيها. لأن صلاح الأرض والسماء بطاعة. For this earth and the heavens to be good, we have to do good deeds. So brothers in Islam, each and every one of us, let's sit down today, reflect upon our actions. Let's ask ourselves, am I the reason that the whole country is suffering? Am I the reason that my brothers in the northern region are suffering? They cannot have water, they cannot have food, the animals are dying. And we all know the qissa of Musa alayhi salam and the time that he had drought in his time. He asked Allah Azza wa Jalla, we want to come and pray you so that you give us the rain. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, ordered him, remove each and every follower of yours to the ground. They all went there. When Musa alayhi salam wanted to start dua, Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed unto him, he said, there is one person in that crowd of yours who has been doing ma'asiyah for almost 40 years. Tell him to get out of that crowd and I will give you the rains. Qawm Musa, they were forbidden rain because of one person. It can be you, it can be me. That we are stopping our brothers back there to get rain. That we are stopping each and every person in this country to have rain because we are doing ma'asiyah after ma'asiyah after ma'asiyah. So now I want you to reflect with me. The same person in the crowd, when Musa alayhi salam said, Inna Allah yaqul, Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, there is someone in this crowd that has been doing ma'asiyah for 40 years. Please get out of this crowd so that we get rains. What happened? The person looked to his right, nobody was getting out. He looked to his left, nobody's moving out. He looked in front, nobody's going. He looked back, no one is going. Then he realized he's the one. He was the one who's being called. He took his cloth, he put on top of his head, and he started doing istighfar. He said, Ya Rab, I have been doing ma'asiyah for 40 years without anyone knowing me. Listen to this word carefully. I have been doing maasiya for 40 years without anyone knowing me. And today I am doing tawbah without anyone knowing me. I ask you, Allah, do not لا تفضحني على رؤوس الخلق. Do not disgrace me in front of all these people. Once he finished that statement, the skies were clean. Musa and his followers started seeing clouds coming together. Musa was shocked. What is happening? Nobody has moved out of this crowd. We are all together here. No one is on the other side. Then he asked Allah Azza wa Jalla, Ya Rabb, ما خرج فينا أحد. No one has come out of this crowd. We are all here together. Nobody is out. And I can see the clouds coming and the rain wants to start falling. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, My servant asked for forgiveness. My servant asked for forgiveness. And because of him, that is why the rain is falling today. It can be you, it can be me. We need to ask Allah for forgiveness. We might be the reasons people are suffering. We might be the reason the continent is suffering. We might be the reason the whole world is suffering. We don't know. Each and every one of us knows his deeds. Let's go back to Allah. Umar ibn Abdulaziz said, "Kana yuqalu inna Allah tabarak wa ta'ala لا يعذب عامة بذنوب الخاصة." That Allah Azza wa Jalla will never punish the general masses because of the mistake of one person. ولكن إذا عمل المنكر جهارا. But if the munkar is done in public without people fearing, استحق العقوبة كلهم. They deserve to be punished, all of them. Imam Malik, rahimahullah, he had a commentary on this statement of Abdullah Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. He said, the reason the good people who are doing good deeds are being punished because of mistakes of others is because they saw the mistakes being done and they kept quiet. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, one day he was sitting with his friends. Then one person said, "Inna al-zalima la yadhurru illa nafsa." The oppressor does not harm, and he only harms himself. He cannot harm anyone else. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, "If," Abu Huraira said, "if this zalim continues doing the zulm and no one is talking about it, no one is correcting him, then that zulm that he's doing is going to be divided according to each and every person who knows it. So they will have a portion of that zulm. And then after that, they will do what? They will deserve to be punished because of that zulm that they saw and kept quiet on." Number two, منع إخراج الزكاة. فهو سبب مباشر لمنع القطر من السماء. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث: ولم يمنع زكاة أموالهم إلا منع القطر من السماء ولولا البهائم لم تمطروا. We have, mashallah, businessmen. We have, mashallah, farmers. Mashallah, we have people who are having animals. They are keeping animals, goat, camels, and cows. But how many of them are giving out zakah?
The Prophet ﷺ said,
ما منع قوم زكاة إلا ابتلاهم الله بالسنين. A group of people will not hold back their zakah, but Allah is going to punish them with sinin. As-sinin al-qahd, drought. Ask yourselves, majority of the places that are having drought is Muslim majority areas. Are we paying our zakah? Can that be another reason why we are not having rains? Can that be a reason why we are being punished, all of us? Because everyone is keeping himself for himself his wealth. No, you know, if I give now, the economy is not good. If I give now, zakah is not the right time to give zakah. So let me hold. Inshallah, when business grows, inshallah, I will give. Don't worry. No problem. Then you become a reason we are all suffering. Because, mashallah, you love your wealth more than anyone else. Because you cannot only give 2.5% and you remain with 97.5% of your wealth. Number three, الكبرياء في الأرض والتعالي على الخلق والافتخار بالمال والجاه أو المنصب أو السلطان فالغيث لا ينزل إلا بإظهار التضرع لله والانكسار بين يديه. قال تعالى ولقد أرسلنا إلى أمم من قبلك فأخذناهم بالبأساء والضراء لعلهم يتضرعون فلولا إذ جاءهم بأسنا تضرعوا ولكن قست قلوبهم وزين لهم الشيطان ما كانوا يعملون. كبرياء كبر ما شاء الله. And the Prophet ﷺ defined the term kibr. He said, "Al-kibr batar al-haqq wa ghamt al-nas." Kibr is you and me not accepting the haqq. That in itself is kibr. You are told Allah said this. The Prophet ﷺ said this. This is the sunnah. No. You're not serious, man. That cannot be sunnah. No, you don't want to accept. That is kibr. وَغَمْتُ النَّاسِ and looking down upon people. Allah Azza wa Jalla is giving us an example. He's saying, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكُمْ and he sent prophets to nations before us. فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ that Allah Azza wa Jalla tested them with bad timings and good. لعلهم يتضرعون maybe they will humble themselves maybe they will humble themselves.
Then what did he say?
فلولا إذ جاءهم بأسنا تضرعوا. But if when our test came onto them they humbled themselves, it could be better for them. But what did they do? ولكن قست قلوبهم their heart were hardened because of what? Ma'asi. Kalla bal rana qulubuhum. Their heart was already like a stone. They cannot think out of their whims and wishes and desires. And Allah said, وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ And shaitan, mashallah, he's the most experienced creature on earth. He was with Adam and now he's dealing with us. So you can imagine someone with that experience. What he can do to you. What he can do to me and what he can do to everyone. وَزَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ أَعْمَالَهُمْ Shaitan, he is very good at that. He's going to show you something very small. MashaAllah. You come to the mosque early, maybe you want to read the Quran. He's going to say, MashaAllah. You see now, Muhammad sees now, mashallah, you nowadays, everybody respects you. See, they are looking at you when you're reading Quran. You see, when you get out of the masjid, people are giving you salam. Mashallah, see, they like you. Mashallah, continue that. He's not telling you don't do it. He cannot tell you don't do it. But what is he doing? He's corrupting your action. He's corrupting your intention. That is all. Once your intention is corrupted, then there's nothing you're doing. So shaitan knows that. He knows how to decorate bad thing and give you, mashallah, You know, we have interior designers nowadays. Massage they put. Shaitan is the interior designer for nafs, whereby he is not decorating it well. He is putting muds and everything, and every bad things on it. He's an interior designer who does not design on the positive side, but on the negative aspect. Number four, التطفيف في الميزان والمكيال. Not giving the right measures. ويل للمطففين الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ولا نقص قوم المكيال إلا ابتلوا بالسنين. وفي الرواية الأخرى, ولا طففوا المكيال إلا حبس عنهم النبات وأخذوا بالسنين. And people will not give the wrong measures when they are dealing with other people unless or until they are being stopped from having nabat. You will not have, farmers will try and farm, they will not get anything. You will try and invest and you will not get anything back. And on top of that, وَابْتُلُوا بِالسِّنِينَ الْقَحْدِ, and you'll be tested with drought. We are living in a time where we are all tested with drought. Brothers in Islam, these four things, let's reflect on it. Let's search ourselves. Are we falling among any of this? Number one or two or three or four or all of it? We need to ask ourselves and reflect on that. If we want to get rains, if we want our brothers and our sisters in the northern region to have rainfall.
أقول ما سمعت مستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه الغفور الرحيم البر الكريم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على نبيه المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن على سبيله اكتفى. أما بعد,
I decided also to come up with four solutions. It is good when you have problems to look for solutions. It is not right to criticize without giving other alternatives. Now, what can we do?
Number one, تقوى الله وإقلاع عن المعاصي. قال تعالى ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض. قال أهل التفسير البركات المطر والنبات. الله عز وجل says,
and if people of a nation feared Allah, Allah will give us barakat min as-sama'i wal-ard. Ahlul tafsir, they say, al-barakat min as-sama' is matar, it is rainfall. So we need to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla.
Number two, al-iktharu min al-istighfari. Qala ta'ala, على لسان نوح فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا.
Let's do استغفار each and every time you're free. Please fill your time with استغفار. While you're driving back home, just do استغفار, 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 استغفار. While you're at home relaxing alone, do istighfar. When or at your office doing nothing, do istighfar. Make sure you do istighfar as much as possible.
وقد حكى الله لنا في كتابه عن نبيه هود عليه السلام حين قال لقومه ويا قوم استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويزيدكم قوة إلى قوتكم. ذكر أهل التفسير أن قوم هود حبس الله عنهم المطر بسبب ذنوبهم 3 سنين. هود عليه السلام,
he reminded his people to do istighfar and tawbah. You know why? Because for 3 years they did not have rains.
What did he tell them?
إن آمنتم أحيى الله بلادكم وزادكم عزا إلى عزكم. If you believe in Allah and come back to Allah, أحيي الله بلادكم. Allah is going to bring back to life your lands. And it's going to increase from your iz to other iz. The last one. كثرة الدعاء. قال تعالى أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء ويجعلكم خلفاء الأرض. We need to do dua a lot. And today being a Friday, the Prophet ﷺ told us that there's a time in Friday where no believer sits down and asks Allah for anything unless Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to give him. So brothers in Islam, being a Friday, let's spare some minutes. Let's spare some time. We go somewhere that no one can see you. Exclude yourself from anyone that you know, even your wife and children if it's possible. Sit down, reflect on your nafs, reflect on your deeds, and ask Allah for forgiveness. Number two, you need to pray for our brothers in the north. They are really suffering. They are really suffering. Yes, our brothers in Syria are suffering. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to help them. Our brothers in Turkey are suffering. We have to also remember them in our dua. But charity begins at home. You cannot have your neighbor dying and you say, I will only focus on someone who is very far. Put each and every Muslim in your dua. I know each and every one of us here knows someone from the northern region, or he's a relative to someone in the northern region, or he's from the northern region. And yet you're very comfortable here, seated, like nothing is happening there. Eating, enjoying with your family, and your friends, neighbors, brothers are suffering, are dying because of hunger and thirst. Brothers in Islam, please, let's make dua for our brothers. ألا وصلوا وسلموا على من أمركم الله بالصلاة والسلام عليه فقال سبحانه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وأن سائر الصحابة أجمعين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين اللهم إنا نستغفرك من جميع الذنوب والخطايا ونتوب إليك اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا اللهم استر عيوبنا اللهم استر عيوبنا اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم اللهم إن لنا إخوانا في شمال كينيا يموتون جوعا اللهم فأسقهم اللهم اسق البلاد والعباد اللهم اسق البلاد والعباد اللهم اسق العباد والبلاد اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا اللهم إنا نستغفرك إنك كنت غفارا فارسل السماء علينا مدرارا اللهم اغفر لإخواننا اللهم اغفر لهم اللهم إنا نستغفر لهم اللهم فاغفر لهم وأنزل عليهم مطرا من السماء اللهم أنزل اللهم ارزقهم اللهم ارزقهم يا رب العالمين اللهم إن لنا إخوانا قد ماتوا جياعا اللهم انصرهم يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا نستغفرك فاغفر لهم اللهم إنا نستغفرك يا ربي فاغفر لنا واغفر لهم اللهم اغفر لهم اللهم اغفر لهم اللهم أنزل علينا من السماء ماء طهورا اللهم أنزل علينا من السماء ماء طهورا لنسقي به بلاد والعباد اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغثنا اللهم أغث البلاد والعباد اللهم إنا اللهم إنا هدنا إليك فاغفر لنا يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا هدنا إليك فاغفر لنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا قد اعترفنا بما كان منا، اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم إننا نعترف بذنوبنا وخطايانا وكل ذلك منا، اللهم اغفر لنا، اللهم امطر علينا مطرا، اللهم اسقنا يا أرحم الراحمين، اللهم اسقنا يا أرحم الراحمين، اللهم لا تعذبنا بما فعل السفهاء منا، اللهم لا تعذبنا بما فعل السفهاء منا، اللهم لا تعذبنا بما فعل السفهاء منا. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله، وأقم الصلاة.